few who are enriching themselves today at the expense of the majority must understand that the majority who are suffering today cannot guarantee the safety of the few who are enriching themselves today. Conformists, now non-conformists, we have become pessimists because of our experiences as optimists. You keep telling us you change our metals to gold, like you are some kind of alchemist. Chemist, you mix light kaolin and sodium hydrogen carbonate for us to offset our stomach upset. You are comfortably up and set. We are down, frustrated and upset because for years we have stomached the various sets of lies you fed us. Poison. Give us one tangible reason why we should not spit in your face next season. It's not all about our monies. It's not all about your cronies. Tell us, family is becoming our worst enemies. Ghana, we have to pray. But hey, we keep praying against these enemies, avoiding them by enemies. But these enemies keep finding enemies to execute their plans. Same group, different class, different item in different cans. NNDPCC, PPPP, New National Democratic Patriotic Convention Congress, Progressive People's Political Parties. Listen, your activities is moving the nation back like the Al-Qaeda dance. Ghana, bravo, Al-Qaeda, why you not doing so? Well, I don't even blame you. I blame those poor souls whose souls were sold in the form of votes to these foes, foes of our souls. You have erected poles for them to score their goals. Goals of corruption, fouls of mismanagement, free kicks of kickbacks, kicking back our freedom, making us losers like the game of chairs. You keep changing them by the musical chairs, and you think that is the solution? When your take-home pay cannot even take you home? When you don't have anything to call your own? See, the meat is left with the bone. Omari Namamanaka Dope, Ghana Dandis Crafts, Yenikoko Kope, and Poya Betomi saying, Yabeche is saying, Musa Ose Yacha, Umenya saying. Let me tell you how they do it. They come words to impress, address the press, promise progress. But after you have given them the yes, they take all the largesse, digress from the espresso to success, stress to impress their masters whilst you live in a mess. You see, life is full of stress and sometimes can hinder one's desire to progress. God has blessed us, yes, and we want to see this nation progress. But why are people working hard to make sure this blessing become a curse? You could not make money out of trotro, and today you are talking about taxes. So many taxes, we don't even know where our taxes. The tax case, we need to identify new taxpayers, not new taxes. Whoever is in charge of our finances, please, if you can't widen the tax net, you better take a back seat. I heard somebody saying, if you widen the tax net, a lot of taxpayers will fall out. So we need an IMF bailout. Joke of the century. Go and read our economic history. Is this not the land of gold? Royal, haven't you found oil? Don't we have fertile soil? So why are our leaders taking us in the spiral road and the mosquito coil? Not even a Rolls Royce. You know, you turn backs. You turn our backs for your selfish gains. I agree that we've made modest economic gains. We've had significant gains. But where are the gains at the front planes? Ghana's food baskets. Ghana, if we don't talk, we'll be choking our words unspoken. They will tell you every project is in the pipeline. Plans are far advanced, measures are being taken. So I ask, why don't you take the measures, plan advance, and clear all those projects in the pipeline? I wish every nation has a deadline, like we see in the banner headline. Ghana is dead, bold, underlined. Thank you.